Welcome back, everyone. It's Alex here giving you some Derp Souls 3 PvP. This is my dex build that I have just recently made, like a day ago. And my loadout, of course, is going to be a hollow dual-wield katanas. I want to call them katanas because I can't say that word. And then I have the Evelyn, that's, you know, of course, when they go to try to use their flask. And for the rings, I use the Havel ring to, you know, give me more rate ratio so I can effectively use this ring and increase my HP, stamina, and maximum equipment load that I will also apply with this ring, and of course my basic increased strength. Now, I was going this boost attacks as long as an attack persists, but that was before I ended up, like, just one-shotting them most of the times, so that ring no longer bull because of the build. Second note that if I go here, I have 392 damage. I'm looking for 400, so probably, like, level 96, level 97, I'll have 400 straight damage. And the rest of that will just go to my endurance and, yeah, just my endurance till I hit level 120, and after that, it'll just be done. Alright, so I showed you the loadout, showed you the build. When you go in to initiate your fight, go ahead and, you know, pop one of these babies, because that will increase the percentage of the bleed. And just after you land this, it was just 1-2, and then sometimes 1-2 if they dodge, and they're dead. Now, occasionally when you go to do this, you get a headshot, and that crit headshot will automatically cause bleed effect, and that's pretty much TKO right there. I have yet found a person to survive a crit headshot with a bleed. I just haven't. Hopefully you guys get to see that today. Alright, so let's go ahead and let me put this down. I have done this plenty of times. I already got 24 of these, and I've only lost like maybe 5 out of them. So I have been doing it for quite a bit. Now, the iron flesh, didn't really mention that. If they have a heavy weapon, oh, damn, look at me. If they have a heavy weapon, put on iron flesh, and as soon as they attack you, swing at them with the, of course, the Carthus Rogue applied, and it's an instant win. Now, I've been also playing off with other covenants. I've already, like, maxed out my Rosier Covenant and my Mad Covenant. This is the only covenant I have left that I haven't maxed, which I will be doing that soon. So I figured I'd go ahead and, you know, show you guys my build that I've been working on. My next build that I'll be posting will be a Faith build that I've actually been quite fond of recently. She's only level 68, but once I hit 95, that's pretty much like the hard cap for when I go to PvP. Show you guys. Now, I like to, since my name is Sacred Assassin, I like to, like, play the part. So you'll see me half the time just, like, do this and just walk up to him. Now, he has a heavy weapon, so I want to go ahead and apply this. And just as soon as he goes to swing at me, and he's gonna do it again. He's gonna wait for that moment. Oh, he healed. Fascinating. Doesn't work all the time, I guess. But you will see the true potential. I've literally been doing this all day. As soon as someone decides they want to go against me, here we go. Alright. I gotta get that cocky attitude away. Literally killed so many people today. Luckily, they didn't put me too far. Now, this guy has a light weapon, but most of the time it also works. Oh no, he has a heavy weapon. Okay. What is this guy doing? Come on, swing. There we go. The health bar was kind of glitchy for me. I don't know if y'all saw that, but as soon as I hit him, it didn't do any damage initially. I think there was like a drawback. It's weird. But no, with this build, if they have a heavy weapon, you always want to have the iron flesh. It goes against them so well. All right, let's do this again. Hopefully, someone will get me. I'll get paired with someone who has a light weapon, so I can show you how to go against them with this build not having iron flesh. But most of the time, you're gonna want iron flesh. That's like your initiator for heavy weapons. I will be updating my heavy set, not heavy set, my strength build, because I have posted my strength PvP not too long ago, and I tweaked it a little bit, and it's gotten to where I can thrust twice and then back step and swing, and surprisingly, that's very effective if they like to roll. I have been in most cases where they just try to avoid getting hit by my Fumi Ultra Greatsword, and it's just devastating how much reliable I can put into that sword just because of the stamina that I have. But I'll leave that with to another video. I probably have like five more PvPs of these. And like I said, this is mainly to show you my build. If you like it, if you need, thinks there are tweaks that needs to be made, That will also be awesome to tell me. What do we have here? Alright, so they have light weapons, so there's absolutely no reason for you to have iron flesh on. He's doing that, but... Oh, wait a minute. Are they both going to try to attack me? Or no? What? I hate stupid fights like this. That was a headshot and crit bleed effect. Oh no! My mistake. He did a smart move. Mostly they would try to just back away, but he didn't do that. That was smart. That was a really good move. It's 6:31 a.m. in the morning. I've been doing this since 12 o'clock p.m. a.m. I need to go to sleep soon. Alright, okay, a couple more times. See, I might want to change up my rings. Let's put less light, increase the damage. Let's put that on. I've got to leave that. Alright, let's try this. So I tweaked a little bit. I replaced the favor ring and applied the punitif right eye. Let's see that combo. I hate when they spawn me so far away. Oh, there he is. Alright, go ahead and apply. Looks like he has a spear. Yeah, he has a spear. Let's go ahead and just do this. He's gonna potion. How unfortunate. I really want to get that head crit though. All it is just as long as you. It went to a loading screen. It's really an effective build, and if you just want to be like an absolutely asshole, just put everything into your decks and hit that 500 marker on your damage. I bet. Oh my god, that would be. Actually, that's not too bad of a bad idea. You'll probably want 40 strength and then just build the rest into dex. Because after 40, that's when it's like it takes 2 points in order to level it. But as long as you land this and then follow up with this, they're dead. If they have very little bleed resistance, it will literally only take this and maybe occasionally a swing. If they're wearing heavy set armor and they're fat rolling, you only have to do this. Literally. They will not go anywhere, I promise you. It's quite broken, I want to say. But then again, they are fat rolling, so I guess that's their punishment. But they cannot escape. The stagger time is just too great. Do I have 26, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Oh, a few more. Oh, there he is. Go ahead and apply this. And he is a mage. I don't want to do this dirty, so come on, be aware. Come on, I'm trying to kill you here. Don't bow. All right. How did that not connect? What? And he's dead. So, as I was saying before, if he would have caught both of my swings that first hit instead of just one of my sword, he would have been dead. Because since he's not wearing armor, that means he has no bleed or pretty much any physical on him. So that would have been a one-hit kill. But since only one of my swords caught him, it took half his HP instead. Now, if I could just get someone who is wearing heavy armor with a heavy weapon, or light weapon, really. Then I can show you a really cool trick of the iron flesh. But one of the major capabilities with these swords is when you do initiate this, as soon as you lift off, you cannot be staggered. Your attack, as long as you can withstand their damage, you will initiate your entire animation. And as once it connects, just swing, swing. It's real easy. How many more I need? This is literally the last covenant I need to max it out. But very soon, I will be showing, or may not showing, making a video of my faith PvP. It works. It's great. I hope you love it as much as I love it. And then coming up after that will be a heavy set build PvP. Pretty much a brick wall. You take that hit, and then once you swing, they are dead. That's where I'm trying to get at with that build. But it's incomplete. Honestly, once they get 70 strength, then it would be done. I mean, I have 10 characters. I do a lot of shit. Alright, where's this guy at? He has a heavy sword. Alright. Sweet. Go ahead and bleed up. Since you have a heavy sword, let's just walk formal. Make him think that this is not iron flesh, but the plus damage instead. And voila! That's the end of him. As I said before, when you go against people with heavy weapons, iron flesh is the way to go. Now, you could also just like maneuver around it and then try to slash them, but then sorry about that, my mic disconnected. As I was saying before, you can you don't have to have iron flesh, but then you'll have to move around, and by time you dodge their swing and get ready to initiate your L2, they'll have time to roll. So that's the whole point of iron flesh with heavy weapons. You have that advantage because they can't just swing and roll. They have to initiate their swing, and then as soon as it hits the ground, they can roll. And that's what makes these weapons so cheap and dirty, because it only takes 2 hits to apply the bleed effect with the Carthus Rogue. It's not entertaining. What am I saying? That's the tiredness talking. It's quite useful and reliable. But I wouldn't recommend doing the iron flesh for, like I said, light weapons, because they do have the maneuverability to just dodge and you'll be slowed. So it would be type of a disadvantage. If they're being cocky and just trying to swing, then oh yeah, go for it. Go for it. They'll learn real quick. They will learn real quick not to F with you. But if they're being cautious and dodging when you're attacking, do not do iron flesh on light weapons. Or not light weapons, but against light weapons. Because, like I said, they'll have the maneuverability to just get behind you and backstab. Took me a while to learn my lesson, so let me go ahead and give y'all guys a heads up. But heavy weapons, all day, every day. Where's my tea? Gotta sip it. Our next contestant. And it would seem we have, kind of hard to make out, light weapons. No, he doesn't have any weapons. He is a mage. Okay. Good thing I ruled that out. Hello, mage. Oh, that is not a bad combo you have there, sir. Not bad, but as all mages downfall, they wear too light. They wear too light. And with this build, you would have to be pretty armored up to just want to just block. Another good thing about this game, blocking, you still apply the bleed or whatever you have on your weapon. And it still calculates the damage that your swords do with your bleed. So with the base health off your bleed weapon, since it takes from a percentage, it's practically hitting them. It's quite good. And of course, if even if they're blocking, once that bleed pops in, you're going to end up staggering them, and then one slice to finish it off. So this set is pretty good as well, because I do see me have like at least I've seen like 40 increase in damage compared to my last one where it was just the Hobble's ring and the favor ring. I do see a bit of increased damage since I am still applying two swings to initiate the final death. So even if they would have lived, the bleed will finish them off. So I guess I'll just stick with this build for now on. And I am not finished with this build. Like I said before, I have my 40 in dexterity. As soon as I get my strength to 40, I'm going to just put everything in my endurance. Or at least get my endurance to 200. And as soon as I get my endurance to 200, I'll build everything to my dexterity. But really, I only need 400. Because that means once I hit 400 damage, as soon as I do that right there, it's going to cause bleed. As long as one sword hits, it should have caused bleed with the rogue. They're not going to even know what hit them. It's scary, actually, how amazing these weapons are. And I have no idea what's going on here, but, you know, fuck it. Okay. What do we have here? I feel like this is just going to be a big hassle. And it looks like they're going to try to kill me. That's great. We have a pyromancer. Or they could be friendly. No, they're not friendly. Okay. He's wearing heavy set. He's pretty heavy. That shouldn't matter though. Let me pop my potion. Hit my health. Oh, he has a heavy weapon. And what did I say before, friends? Heavy weapon, you do this. I did that one too many times. Come on, hit me. Hit me. Hit me! Okay. He played that smart. He knew exactly what was up. Oh. Oh, that is terrifying. I'm dead. Oh, yep. He had played that very well. He probably had already been in a similar situation with this build. I'm not saying this build is new. Could be common. Actually, it might be common. He understood exactly what was up. That was good. That was really good. He knew not to attack when I was while I had iron flesh. He knew to change his weapon. He also knew that he could get two hits before I was able to roll. That is some experience right there, guys. Alright. About to be 7 a.m. And even though I said it would just be a few, I've gotten addicted to this PvP. And I might just play till, I guess, I get my 30. Which is one more. Look at there. I only need one more. Oh, man. Okay, so this could be it, guys. And I'm off to bed. But as long as y'all get the concept, if y'all have any questions, and of course, I'm constantly tweaking these builds. Constantly tweaking these builds. My weapon's almost shattered. We don't want that. Put some sparkle dust on that. And we have... Is that an... I'm not sure. I think he has an arrow. Does he have a bow? No, that's a sword. Okay. It's a light sword, so we do not want to have iron flesh. He's gonna pop that. I'm gonna do this. That's two for two. Alright. He's probably gonna be more cautious. He's two-handing now. He's gonna probably get that poise, but he obviously doesn't understand that this build don't give two fucks about your poise. Why did I apply that? I need my potion. He has a heavy weapon now. And as I said before, as long as he has a heavy weapon, you want to use iron flesh. But of course, he just switched. You are no fun. Matter of fact, hit me up. Go ahead and hit me. Let's see how that works out for you. Oh, good shit. I could die? Possibly? 1 HP? Roll? Drink HP? Oh shit. That was good. That was good. That was a good block. Or crit, I guess. I don't forgot what to call it. You can't block. You cannot. I got him. He did not know. Excuse me. He did not know that you cannot parry that. That animation, you cannot parry. Oh, man. Oh, man. That was really good. If he would have known that, he wouldn't have parried. Love it. When you go get someone who does not know your build, it's absolutely flawless. It feels great. Yeah, but another thing I should have mentioned, you cannot parry that. As soon as you lift off, as soon as you do this, you will not stop the animation. It will do the entire animation. I have 30 now? So I might get an extra tongue. No, I don't need a tongue. I finished that. Whatever. I'll do a... I need 5 more mad. 4 more mad. Or was it 4? No, shackle. two. I need three to finish that one because I already had put 25 into it. So I'll switch to Mad Covenant. And I guess I could play this through five more times. I don't like doing useless stuff. Like, I'm showing you guys because it's just convenient. I'm finishing my stuff. All about efficiency, I guess. But these weapons are really good. I did have the, what gem was it? Sharp gem, I believe, for the dexterity. But since I'm hollowfied, it just gave me more of what I was looking for. Surprisingly enough, it still scaled well with my dex. So the hollow, if you're going hollowfied, they get the ample strength. Hollowing your weapon, if it's a dex anyways, is really good. I can't wait to show you guys my healer PvP. It's quite amusing. You wouldn't believe the crap I've been pulling off with her. Alright, I think that's an Ultra Sword? Yeah, it's an Ultra Sword. Hello, man. I'm gonna put that Ultra Sword to shame. I'm gonna make you regret having that big long sword. Come on, hit me before it runs out. Damn it. You do not know the rules. You have to hit me. She probably could know. Yeah, she knows. She knows. I shouldn't have wasted it. Oh, shit. I wasn't dual wielding. And goodbye. And ladies and gentlemen, that was a head crit with bleed stack. As I said before, head crit with bleed stack is instant death with this build. We are going into 40 minutes. That is quite a bit. I'm having so much fun. Absolutely having so much fun. And I thought I was addicted to my strength build. Whew. Man. You know, I should actually show you guys some of my gameplay. Because I hit 95 in a few hours. It literally takes me a few hours to hit 95. I'm not even bullshitting with you. Since we are hitting 40 minutes, I will end this one. This will be my last one. Because we are tipping into 40 minutes. I don't want to make this video stupid long. Because as soon as I wake up, I have to hop onto my healer build. And start tweaking that up for PvP to show you guys. If there's any specific weapon you guys think might work for PvP, y'all want me to try out. Literally, I play this game for shits and giggles. I'll do absolutely anything that I see of interest. So like, just put down a weapon that you want me to try out. I'll show you if it's good or not. I'll of course play at least roughly 50 games, 50 PvP with that weapon before I'll actually stream it. To make sure that I understand the frames for it. And I literally play Dark Souls 3 every day. If y'all want to play with me, my PS4 account would be death underscore underscore cries. Hit me up sometimes. I would love to play with y'all. With you all. Oh, my speech. 7 a.m. Yeah, I'm getting up at 4 hours to just play this game. Addicted? Absolutely. Probably because I like murdering people. Okay. Anyways, initiate your rogue. Confirm his weapon. It's a light weapon, so you do not have to go iron flesh. Oh, it's claws. I think I've already beaten this guy before. He wasn't using claws. Interesting. Well, let's see if I can initiate it. Oh, you rolled. Oh, good. Good. Oh, wait, wait. No, I'm not dead. Unless he has the hornet ring. That was good. Not bad at all. Prompt for you. He's gonna learn today. He's using a heavy weapon. Big mistake. Absolutely big mistake. I love it when they use heavy weapons. He's trying to parry me. Maybe I can get him like this. Yeah, he thinks he can parry it. As long as they think they can parry this, that's all that matters. Because once it connects. Once it connects with both the swords. He's being too cautious of my weapons. And actually, my bleed is off. Let's reapply that. Ah, I only hit with one. Very crucial that you connect with both of your katanas. And since I have no mana, it's not gonna land too easily. There we go. Alright, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up with that. But as I said before, any questions, if you think you can improve it, or if you absolutely love it and want further details of how I'm going to go with it, let me know. I'll give you a full breakdown and a comment in the comments below. I know it'll be soon. Not today or tomorrow, but it will be soon, and I will post or make a video of my PvP healer. Are gonna absolutely love it. I want to say it's like a troll, but That's the thing. It's not really a troll. It's good. It works. I don't do things that don't work. I just don't. I see it as pointless. If it has the potential to be good, then I'll work with it. But if I absolutely see the stats and break down the damage that I will be end up doing, it might have a fancy move set, but it's not gonna just initiate in the end. But I rambled on too much. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like if you liked it. And subscribe if you want to see more. Alright. Oops, that's the wrong button.